like a bell cut.
Thank you.
People waste a lot of time. Then they wish for more. Want more hours in their days? More days in their years? More years in their lives? Because if they had all that extra time, they could fix any mistake. I don't need hours or days or years. I only need seconds. Here's the thing about time. If you can't make the most out of any given moment, then you don't deserve a single extra second.
The Freljord. A frozen, desolate place. War is coming to the Freljord. The Averrosen, the largest and strongest of the tribes. Led by Ash, they seek peaceful unification. The Winter's Claw, the most warlike and brutal of the tribes. Led by Sejuani, they think peace is another word for weakness. Sejuani has sworn to purge this weakness. Through war, the Freljord will be purified. Far in the north, the peaceful Frostguard protect Freljord's ancient secrets. Or so the world believes. In truth, the Frostguard protect me, Lysandra. While others bicker, we prepare. When the time is right, we will strike. They cannot withstand us. They are only human. And when the war is over, the world, our world, will be reborn in ice.
There are many tales about Braum, the heart of the Freljord. They say he could chop down trees with his bare hands. If anyone needed help, he would be there in an instant. He was just a man, yet to our village, he was a hero. When a troll boy was trapped, not even the mountain could stand in his way. With a door as his shield, he could brave any threat. The smallest of lives were saved. But the world is a big place, and Braum knew this too. So he set off, knowing his tales were not through.
Child in Valoran has heard the tale before about the cursed mommy boy who felt his heart no more. So sad and lorn, the helpless lad, Amumu was his name. He ventured out to find a friend and learn about his bane. Speak. began to whisper in his ear. It would confirm what was Amumu's biggest fear. It pledged that never shall someone become his friend. It pledged that he shall be alone until his end. Sorrow and despair became too much to bear. Tantrum that he never could control.
Thank you for waiting. Accessing. Thank you for waiting. Accessing.
Thank you. tragic fall of Shirima was nothing compared to the tragedy of its rise from the grave. In a market on the edge of the desert, a stranger appears. Cassiopeia, a noble woman of Noxus, looking to hire a guide to take her to the fabled lost city. But not just any guide. She hires the owner of a legendary ancient blade, the mercenary, called Sivir. Sivir gathers her band of sellswords, and they set out into the desert to find the buried bones of Shirima. 5 days beneath the broiling sun, a scout spots towers jutting from the dunes, and a stairway leading underground. They climb down into the darkness. Ancient treasures gleam in the torchlight. Even Sivir is astonished at the grandeur of the ruins. Her men head deeper in, only to stumble into traps and be eviscerated. Sivir is stunned with horror, but Cassiopeia does not flinch. She sees only the statue of a huge serpent silently guarding the door to the tomb of the emperors, and smiles. The ancient weapon is a key. Cassiopeia betrays Sivir. She picks up Sivir's blade, puts it into the lock. The guardian's curse is triggered. The stone serpent comes alive. It pins Cassiopeia in its jaws. The venom sears her flesh like acid. The tomb door opens. Renekton emerges, the brother I loved and locked away, twisted beyond insanity, followed by Xerath, the architect of his torment. My failure is complete. Sivir drags herself away, lifeblood flooding from her wound, and then succumbs to darkness. Behold Shirima's legacy. Sivir lies betrayed and bleeding. Something incredible occurs. For though she does not know it, Sivir is the last in the bloodline of Azir, Shirima's lost emperor. And as her blood soaks into the ancient sands, a deep magic sparks to life. Resurrection. First, Azir's mind. Then, his body, snatched back from oblivion to be reborn. Then he sees Sivir, wonders at her face. He sees himself in this daughter of Shirima. In that moment, he has no thought of empires or rituals. He only knows she needs his help. He must take her to the Oasis of the Dawn, the Mother of Life. He smells the waters, smells of life. He praises in time. He does not dream that he, Shirima's greatest emperor, can at long last earn his ascension and bring back his broken city. He dares not dream that if he can save her, Azir can save them all.
Many are the grim tales told of the Shadow Isles and the black mist that shrouds them. And while all good folk shun this cursed land, sometimes its darkness comes for you. The black mist ebbs and flows like the tide. Yet now and then, on a night much like tonight, it reaches far across the sea, searching, seeking, killing. This time is known as the Harrowing. During the Harrowing, the spirits of the Shadow Isles go forth within the black mist.
I wanted to. It ain't about the money. it's all about the money.
With my dying breath, I offer my soul to thee, Lady of Vengeance. Let justice be done.
Pledge accepted.
What are you?
We are the Spear of Vengeance. We come for you, deceiver.
Not a chance.
Innocent blood, stain your hands.
Open, Samuel!
Your arc is over.